Hello guys from Vittorio. Lazio Bologna just finished 3-3. It wasn't a very important match for Lazio, but it was for Bologna that with this point is officially safe. We can say that Sinisa Mihajlović did a real miracle. If you think what Bologna we were seeing last year until January, when Inzaghi, Filippo was the manager of that Bologna, and what happened afterwards, Mihajlović has been terrific. But today we're talking mainly about Lazio. So I was really curious to see Guerrieri playing, and I'm not so happy, I have to be honest. The first goal is a mistake of Guerrieri, who anticipates Pioli and thinks he's gonna cross and moves to the left side, leaving the first post all free, and Pioli scores there. Apart from that, he hasn't been bad. He made a couple of nice exits outside the box, but Bologna shot on target like 3 times and scored in the second half, which is never that nice for a goalkeeper. So yeah, I was hoping to see something better from Guerrieri, unfortunately. I fear that this is the reason why he's not playing. So I'm hoping next year he's gonna go on loan and play and show everybody what he's capable of. I think this maybe could be because of inexperience, the mistake he made today. So it's very important for him to play. And then let's talk about Tuco Correa, because first half of Correa was unbelievable. And you can see why he's such a good player. I think he's better than Felipe Anderson. He can be, more decisive than Felipe Anderson. The problem with Correa is he played 45 minutes really, really good. The second half, he pretty much didn't play. Yes, it was raining heavily. That's not the perfect condition for him. But still, if you are in top form like he is, you should perform for 90 minutes. So I want to see that one, that thing, seeing Correa playing for 90 minutes, not only 45. Ciro Immobile, unlucky. You can see that he was trying to score every chance he had. Maybe in the first half, he should have put the ball back in the box instead of shooting on the first post. It's not the Ciro Immobile of last year, let's put it like that. All the other players of the role, I thought they played well. Incredible performance from Bastos. The goal he scored was unbelievable. I know Alistair is still excited after that. So maybe he's going to be the new striker of Lazio next year after what he did today. But even in defense, he played really well. So good performance from Bastos again. And let's talk a little bit about Armini. If you saw my videos, I've been talking about him in the Primavera. He's the captain of the Primavera. He's 17 years old, so he's 1 year younger than all the other players in the Primavera. So I thought, well, maybe the first team is a little bit too much for him. I saw him playing today. He looks like a veteran. He was unbelievable. You could see in the first half, Palacio was creating a lot of chances. Armini came in and Palacio disappeared. And it wasn't only Palacio. Everybody who was near Armini struggled. And as well, when he had the chance to attack, you could see he has the character. He's mentally ready. The opposite of Guerrieri, I would say. He's ready. So I think next year he can move directly in the Lazio prima squadra, because he's ready. I think he is. And when you have a youngster of that talent, you don't have to wait. You have to throw it in the field and see how he reacts. Because if he reacts well, then he's going to be a champion. If you wait, you'll never know. And maybe it will happen like Guerrieri. 23 years old, he's making the debut in Serie A and don't look that well. So this is my opinion, honestly. The rest, Milinkovic-Savic is getting used to it, right? He comes in the Coppa Italia and scores. He comes in against Bologna and scores. That's the star, you know, that's the champion. He's getting back to the level he is. And he said one thing really, really important. They said, Milinkovic-Savic, what about your future? And he said, I just renewed my contract. I'm here in Rome. This is very good. I really like what he said. What's your thought about Lazio Bologna? Write it in the comment below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then please do. Because every day, a new video about Lazio. Bye.